We are doing a yoga session today. I have my affirmation cards here and I'm going to pick one at random for us. My energy is light, my mind is clear, and my heart is soft. Thank you for joining me. Tonight I have a block and a strap and I hope you enjoy. Get some tunes on for us. Find a nice comfortable seat. Hopefully you're feeling warm. Put your hands before heart space. And just bring yourself to the space you've created. Chest or belly to rise naturally as with each inhalation. I'm going to introduce you to Kumbhacha, which is breath retention, internal breath retention. So we're going to take the breath in for the count of four through the nose. Retain the breath for the count of one. Holding the breath in just for a moment and then exhaling through the nose for the count of four. Inhaling. Retain the breath and exhaling. Opening the eyes, adjusting to the light, if you have light in your room. Interlace the fingers, takes palms up towards the ceiling. Gentle upper thoracic back bend here. Opening the palms, taking it over the left side body, have a gentle twist here. If it's there for you, might like to take that back palm over here. Coming back into your twist. Inhale, scooping up, finding gentle twists here. If it's there for you, take that back palm over here. Coming back to center. Hands before heart space, send the fingertips forward, moving through the wrists. Changing direction. Let's just warm up through all the joints, elbows, extend, touching shoulder. Hands on shoulders, opening up the chest space, lift the chest up. Round through the shoulders towards the back of the room. Release control. Changing direction, bring your shoulders forward, soften through the shoulders space. Gentle stretch here, take arm across front body.
I release control.
Jump on your bed.
And surrender to
changing over.
Of love that
why do you have to do this now? On your bed.
I release control. And surrender to the
hands under, interlace the fingers, hands underneath the chin. Take the elbows up here, keep the shoulders low.
I release control and surrender.
Neutral through the neck here, belly drawn in. Bring the elbows together here, and as you bring the elbows together, draw the chin up.
And surrender to
Slide bring your chin back to neutral. Job. Bring the knee in. Extend out. Bring it in. Extend out. Place the foot in the small of. Just stretch that leg out. If it's easy for you, hold on to the foot. If you have the flexibility or range, bring it up into the elbow. A little rocking. Just moving through all the joints before we get into our practice. Very important. Bring the knee into the chest. Extend that leg out. Belly lifts. If we're slouching, we want to sit up nice and tall. Take that opposite hand underneath the sole of the foot. Take that palm towards back body. Open up here. Gentle twist.
And surrender.
Coming back. Down. Bring the knee into chest. Extend. Knee into chest. Rock here. If you have the range, bring it up into that elbow space. Feeling a bit tight for the glutes today, so just take it easy. A little rocking here. Knee into the armpit, extend the leg out. Be mindful we're not hyperextending the leg or slouching. We want to sit up nice and tall. Right shoulder down and back. Take the opposite hand underneath the sole of the foot. Opening up opposite side body. Nice twist here. Good job. Coming back to center. Knee in. Extend. Roll through the ankles. Changing direction. Good job. Placing the hands at the side body. Press the hands into the mat, toes pointed up towards the ceiling. So active through the legs here. Everything is switched on. We're not kind of hanging out. Lifting, belly lifts, chest lifts. Soften through the jaw. Push the mat away. Almost as if you're lifting your tailbone off the mat, toes towards the ceiling. Everything should be activated here. Final breath here. Jaw release. Slightly bend through the knees. Press the feet into the mat. Take the palms, one palm back. Coming up into reverse tabletop. So drive the hips up. Then drop the head back. Release through the neck. Sit the tailbone down to meet with the wrists. Good. Inhale, arms up overhead, belly draws in, lower ribs tuck in. Exhale, folding forward. This is where if you have your strap handy, you can place it on the sole of the feet. Inhale, scooping up. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale, lift. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale, lift. Fold forward. Well, on our next inhale, we're going to hold our forward fold. Forward fold. Using your strap. Sorry, Murray. Holding your strap. Lift up. Belly draws in. Exhale. Fold forward more deeply. Or if the hands are on the shins, draw yourself down. Now, check in with that back that we're not compromising through the neck. We want to lift, lead with that chest, hinge at the waist. Hinging here.
I release control and surrender to the flow.
Do you want to go outside, Murray? You want to go outside? Excuse me, 1 second. Stay in your forward bow. Thank you. the legs straight, press the heels into the mat, take the hips up towards the ceiling, reverse plank. One more breath here. Release, take the tailbone down to meet with the palms. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, fold forward. Squeeze the legs coming up. Take the leg on the inside of that extended leg. Inhale, check that that foot is in the middle of the breastbone here. Fold forward. Option to have your strap or hold on here. We're going to take it out to the side now. Take that front palm across the body. Keep that engagement here in that forward fold, but we're opening up the chest up and overhead. So you should be feeling it through the back side body. Coming on top of that knee, extend up overhead, back down, changing sides, re-check your alignment here in the middle here, exhale, folding forward, hinging at the waist rather than collapsing through the neck. That front palm across the front body, opening up the ribs. Change that forward fold, coming on top of that knee, palm back body, heels up. Coming back down to seated. Good job. Just going to stay this way. Circle through the hips. Lift the chest. Tugging. Lift. We're going to change direction. To top of our knees, finding ourselves in our tabletop position, moving through cat-cow, inhale, gaze up, gently massaging through the abdominal, tucking the tailbone in, and gazing up into the belly button. Sinking down into child, we're taking a child wide here, so knees wide, take your chest all the way through. Checking that that weight is not in the front body, we want to take the weight towards the back body here. Just moving freely through the hips. Whatever you need to do to enjoy your down dog, shifting the weight towards the back of the room, tailbone high, working the heels down towards the mat. Right leg to raise, point through the toe, looking towards the front of the mat, bring the knee into the chest, shifting the weight forward, back into three-legged dog, taking the knee, the foot down rather, opposite side, left leg to raise, work that heel down, knee into chest, shifting the weight forward, back, three-legged dog. Take the feet back down, planting into your down-facing dog. We're going to shift the weight forward, or bring the gaze forward rather than shift the weight forward. Do a little push-up here, so working through the shoulders. Just keep your alignment here, bend through the elbows towards the outside. Back up. One more time here. Developing a little bit of strength here. My hands are a little slippy, so I'm just going to use my strap on my mat. Hopefully, my legs slip as much. That's better. All right, finding down dog. Get your alignment. Look forward. Bend through the elbows. Work the head down. Developing that shoulder strength here. One more time. Looking slightly forward. Alignment's still there. Bend through. Good job. Right leg to raise, finding three-legged dog. Knee into chest, then move forward. High up on that back tippy toe, grounding through that front leg, or you can carry the leg forward. Straighten through both legs, both heels come down to the mat. Inhale, lift and lengthen. This is where you can have your block handy. Lift and lengthen. Be mindful not to hyperextend here through the right knee. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen. Make that hip push back. Good job. Release into a lunge. Take that back foot at a 45 degree angle. Inhale. Finding warrior one. Opening into warrior two. Moving through your flow here. Reversing your warrior. And taking both palms all the way down to the mat. Place the left hand on a block on the inside of the foot. Opening up. Taking that top palm down onto the outer edge of the foot. Grounding that back heel. Opening up here. Taking it back down. Take that foot back into your downward facing dog. Option to go through a chaturanga flow if you want a little stronger practice. I'll demonstrate it for you, but you don't have to do this. Bend through the elbows, tops of the feet, upward facing dog, back to down dog. So the option's there for you to take that flow
There's a variation on the knees as well. I'll also demonstrate just for the purpose of you know what it looks like. Take it down, lift up, push back up, bend down dog. So we're meeting in down dog. Weight towards the back of the room. Drive the heels down, left leg, opposite leg to raise here. Bring the knee into the chest. Begin to shift that weight forward. If it's there for you, take the leg all the way through or carry it through. Both heels to plant on the mat. Straighten through the front and back leg. Inhale, lift the heart, the head, lengthen. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale to fold. Good job. Bend through that front knee, grounding through that back leg. Draw arms up, fighting warrior. Moving through your warrior flow, coming into second, reversing. And taking palms all the way down, finding that block or book. Take that back leg up, opening here. Taking it down, grounding that heel, opening out to the other side. 90 degree bend here. Take both palms down. Take your variation here if you're moving through a chaturanga flow or if you're just meeting in down and facing dog. I'll meet you in down dog shortly or you can join me in this flow. Just going to scooch over a wee bit so that I don't hit the wall. Hopefully I'm still in the shot. Raise right leg. Bring the knee into the chest. We're going to shift that weight over to the left side and land that foot. Release that left palm up towards the ceiling. Drive the hips up. Take that left palm back down. We're going to step through with that right foot. Take that left knee down. Bringing ourselves up. This is where if you have a block, it's handy. Okay. Inhale. Gentle side. Stretch here. Another side. Good job. Place hands on hips. Wriggle that front foot forward if you have the flexibility in the hip flexors here. You could even just move the flesh out of the way. Sink deep into that hip space here. If you are working on going a little deeper, you can take that front leg forward and use the block to support you and take you into a deeper stretch. Just be mindful of where you're working, yeah? But just for the purpose of, I guess, demonstrating what it looks like, if you're working on getting into Hanumasana, which is your splits, you can give this a try. So sink down, drive that hip down. If you're not using your block, you bring it up a little to 90. Quite 90, and you sink here. So both variations are good for opening up through the hip flexors and the adductors. Gonna straighten through now, through that front leg. Shift a wee bit more forward, coming the toes up towards the ceiling. Sink down, feel that stretch nice through that back leg, or you can come further down. And straighten through that front leg and come to sit. So we want to work on straightening through the front wherever you're at. So if you're really working towards doing the splits, go ahead and do that. Or take a variation where you're sitting back a little more deeply. Hopefully that makes sense. Slowly, slowly, come back out. Bring knees together. Sink down into child. One breath here. Coming back up, moving to the other side. Bring yourself into downward facing dog. Raise left leg. Bring the knee into the chest. Shift the weight forward. Take that left knee to right side body. Straighten through the left leg. Plant the foot on the mat. Release right palm up towards the ceiling. Drive hips up towards the ceiling. Take that palm back down, knee into chest, shift the weight forward, take that back knee down, top of the feet, in, arms up, right side body, lifting up, left side body, inhale, folding forward, using your block if you are, planning to work a little deeper. If you're staying here, super fine. Just come up, make sure that you have that 90 degree. Make sure that the knees are not moving beyond the toes because that's we don't want to take that load into the ankle. So because I want to work a little deeper tonight, much tighter on this side. So I'll see how we go. But just work within your range, please. It's important you try and stay safe. The breath. Make sure that that hip is drawn down. One more breath here. Take a variation here, straightening through the front leg. Option to sink the tailbone down and have a straightened leg and toes pointed towards the front, or to go a little deeper, straighten through, the front leg, toes up towards the ceiling. Bring yourself back into a downward facing dog, walking forward, holding in forward fold here. Release the elbows and palms, rather hold onto the elbows. Just swaying left and right. Bend through the knees, inhale, come to stand. Hands before heart space. Right leg up towards the ceiling, have a wall there for you to support or chair. Bend through the knee, take the knees in alignment, extend left palm forward, pivoting here. I'm just checking my wall back there. We're pivoting at the waist, hinging forward, belly's drawn in, extend arm and kick the foot back. Let go of the foot, extend the palms arms forward, point through the toe. Warrior three. Place palms down, bring yourself into forward fold. Inhale, slowly, slowly. Extend. down together. Extend right palm forward, hinging at the waist here. Kick the back foot, but holding on with the palms. Releasing the foot, fingertips towards the front of the room. Warrior three, nice and strong. Fold forward, bring yourself into forward fold. Inhale. Hands before heart space. Inhale, scoop up. Cross body. Center. Other side. Center, exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come back up. Hands before heart space. Inhale, bend through the knees, posteriorly rotate through the hips, so we're not tucking the tailbone out, we're tucking in. Sink down, hands before heart space. Coming into chair, equal angles for ankles, knees and hips. Nice and strong. Strong in the sense that everything's engaged. Awareness to the pelvic floor, awareness to the abdomen. Find stillness here now. Option to extend palms up overhead, arms in alignment with the ears. Hands before heart space, step the feet together. Left knee over right knee, opening up here. Checking that both knees are still bent. Hands before heart space. Other side. Center, exhale, fold forward, hands on shins, lift up, make yourself into an L, lengthen through the crown, exhale, fold forward, step back into plank, downward facing dog. Bring the knees down towards the mat. Bring the hands on top of the tailbone, knees together, inhale, lift, bring the gaze up towards the ceiling. Slowly bring chin to chest, sink the tailbone down, finding extended child, bending through the elbows, palms towards the back of the head. Send palms forward, walking over right side body. Coming back to center, moving over left side body. Draw the armpit down towards the back. Coming back to center. Slide the hands back up, bring yourself into a seated position. Arms overhead, gentle twist here. If it's there for you, take the back palm overhead. Or stay in your twist, whichever variation you choose. Going back into your twist, bringing yourself to center. Inhale, lift. Exhale. Take your variation. Bring yourself back into a twist. Finding center. Hands over the top of the knees, moving through the hips. I'm changing direction.
you so much for sharing your energy with me this evening or morning. I hope you're keeping well and find comfort in this little community we've created. To your hands, to third eye, to mouth and to heart. May you speak to yourself and others with kindness and compassion. Namaste.